So you're passed out, you're sleeping deeply, you're feeling great. And you may not know it though, but while you're asleep, you're going through numerous 90-minute sleep cycles. And in each sleep cycle, you're going through 4 sleep stages. So I wanna talk about each sleep stage one by one. What's happening during that sleep stage and what happens if you wake up during that sleep stage. Let's get started right now. So I wanna talk about what's happening in each sleep stage, but if at any point you want more information about sleep stages or sleep cycles, Google Mattress Clarity plus sleep cycles to read our entire written article. But what's exactly happening here? Well, we have a 90-minute sleep cycle, and in that sleep cycle, we have 4 sleep stages. Now, the first 3 fall under what's called non-rapid eye movement, and the 4th stage is REM sleep, not REM sleep like the awesome band, but rapid eye movement. And what's happening is we're moving every 90 minutes from lighter sleep, we're getting deeper and deeper until we get into REM sleep where our vivid dreaming happens. And when that stage ends, we start all over again with stage 1. So we're going from lighter to deeper a couple times a night. So I want to talk now exactly what's happening in stage 1. So stage 1 is also known as light sleep. This usually lasts for between 1 and 7 minutes. Now, this is a stage where you're moving from being awake to moving into sleep. So from wakefulness to sleep. Now, when you're in stage 1, what's happening is your muscles start to relax, your eye movement starts to slow down, your brain activity slows down, your heartbeat slows down, and your breathing slows down. Now, when you're in the stage, you're sleeping very, very lightly. So it's very easy to wake up during this stage. So if someone moves around in your room, you could wake up, a light, a sound can make you easily wake up. Now, if you wake up, you could feel like you were sleeping very deeply and you just came out of a deep sleep. You could also wake up feeling very groggy. So a couple of things could happen when you're waking up from stage 1. Next up, we have stage 2, which is also known as intermediate sleep. Now, this stage lasts for about 25 minutes. Now, during stage 2, your heartbeat continues to slow down, your breathing slows down, your eye movements slow down, your muscles, they continue to relax, your brain activity is also slowing down, and your body temperature starts to lower. Now, while you're sleeping more deeply than you were sleeping during stage 1, you are still sleeping somewhat lightly. So, if a sound goes off in your room, the lights go on, you could wake up very quickly. But if you do wake up during stage 2, you shouldn't feel too groggy. And then we have stage 3, which is also known as deep sleep or slow wave sleep. So during stage 3, this is very, very important. Your muscles are recovering, your muscles are growing, bone growth, bone recovery, your immune system is strengthened. So because of especially the muscle recovery and the bone recovery, if you are an athlete, this is a very, very important stage. Or if you work out a lot, I don't do that, but still a very, very important stage. Now, during the stage, your muscles are as relaxed as they're going to be. Your breathing is very slow. Your heart rate is very low, as low as going to be during any sleep stage. So you're sleeping very, very deeply, and it's hard to wake up during stage 3. Light goes on in your room, you hear a loud noise, you shouldn't wake up. But if you do wake up, you're going to feel very, very groggy. Last up, we have stage 4, REM sleep, rapid eye movement. And that stands for when your eyes are rapidly moving behind your eyelids. Also, this is when your body's going into beast mode. Now, during this stage, your heartbeat actually increases, your blood pressure goes up, your breathing increases and becomes more irregular. At the same time, your legs and your arms, they're paralyzed. Now, that happens because you don't want to be physically acting out your dreams. And while you can dream in all 4 stages, your most vivid dreams are going to happen during stage 4. So you don't want to act those out in real life. At the same time, during stage 4, a lot of learning is happening, your memories are being stored, and your mood is also being regulated. So why is all this important? How can you use this information? Well, first off, it's a great thing to consider if you take a lot of naps. I love to nap, and you wanna make sure if you're taking a nap, you're waking up during the right sleep stage. So let's do the math here. You wanna wake up during sleep stage 2, so the 2nd stage of sleep. Now, this is gonna be between 10 and 30 minutes. So if you're waking up during that sleep stage, you're gonna wake up feeling nice and refreshed, not groggy whatsoever. You go into stage 3 and stage 4, you're sleeping more deeply, you wake up actually feeling worse than when you went to sleep. Now, if you want to do a longer nap, you're going to want to go all the way for 90 minutes and do an entire sleep cycle. So again, you wake up feeling refreshed, not in those later stages of stage 3 and stage 4. If you want more information about naps or you want to get the best nap possible, just Google Mattress Clarity plus naps. But another reason besides naps to consider your sleep stage is to make sure you're getting the right amount of sleep. So if you're waking up every morning in the middle of stage 3, you're gonna wake up feeling very, very groggy. So take the information we've talked about, do the math, make sure you're getting the proper amount of sleep. But how much sleep should you be getting? So according to the National Sleep Foundation, teenagers between 14 and 17 should be getting 8 to 10 hours of sleep per night. Adults between 18 and 64 should be getting 7 to 9 hours of sleep per night. And the elderly over 65 years of age should be getting 7 to 8 hours of sleep per night. Now, that's how much we should be getting per night, but as you may or may not know, a lot of us are not sleeping the right amount. And as we get older, it gets harder and harder to get the proper amount of sleep. And not just that, it's harder to get the deep sleep we need. So studies have shown that as you grow older, it's harder to get into stages of 3 and 4. So a lot of elderly sleepers spend more time in stages 1 and 2. They don't get that deep, restful sleep of stages 3 and 4. But whether you're old or young, there are some steps you can take to make sure you get the best sleep possible. First off, make sure your bedroom is cool, dark, and quiet. Personally, I like sleeping in a very cold bedroom, so I set my temperature to around 71 degrees. Now, you also want to make sure it's dark, and if you live in a well-lit area, that might be an issue, but you can easily invest in some blackout curtains. If you want help hanging your blackout curtains, just Google Mattress Clarity Plus blackout curtains for some very easy to follow instructions for hanging those curtains. You also might want to invest in a sleep mask to block out that light, or some earplugs to block out any excess sound. And again, check out our roundups for those products as well. Next up, you want to make sure you're keeping a regular sleep schedule. That means going to bed at the same time every night and waking up the same time every morning, even on weekends. Once you find that sleep schedule that works for you, keeping it the same is going to be very helpful to maintaining a very steady circadian rhythm. Now, I know it's hard because we like to sleep on Saturday mornings, but try to wake up as early as possible, keeping that sleep schedule as similar to the week as you can. You also want to be thinking about what you're eating and what you're drinking during the day. So while caffeine, whether it be coffee or soda, is okay earlier in the day, having caffeine in the afternoon or the evening can seriously disrupt your sleep. Also, alcohol can disrupt your sleep. Namely, it can make you wake up, have to go to the bathroom more often. Also, it does reduce your REM sleep, so not great for proper sleep. Also, you want to think about what you're eating, especially close to bedtime. So spicy and heavy foods in the hour before bed can disrupt your sleep. And while I love my chicken wings, I've had to make sure I'm not eating them an hour before I go to sleep. Last up, you want to avoid screen time before bed. That could be TVs, laptops, tablets, or your phone. And believe me, I'm as guilty of this as anyone. I love lying in bed, checking out Facebook, looking at YouTube, but I have to try to not do that before I go to bed. Instead, try adopting a more relaxing bedtime routine. That could be taking a hot bath, taking a hot shower, reading an actual book, not an e-reader, but an actual book, or even meditating. In the end, you should be able to use this information to get the best sleep possible. But if you're still a little bit confused about sleep cycles or sleep stages, do check out our written article, or you can leave a question or a comment below. But that's about it. If you're getting started looking for a mattress or bedding products, do check out mattressclarity.com. We also do a lot of videos just like this, so hit the like button and subscribe.